In terms of dealing with orbits, it is important to actually derive some expressions for specific points. And this is all based on our capacity to derive this expression that we've seen. And if you have doubts, just let me know. So what we're going to have a look very quickly is how you derive expressions to get essentially the location of what we call the periapsis, the closest point from an object to where it's orbiting, and the apoapsis, which is the furthest point in an orbit. So a very easy way to do this is if you just take the expression on the top and you realize from the ellipse and go back to the whiteboard video if you have to, on the closest approach, the angle theta has to be zero. And this implies that cos theta becomes one. And you can rewrite this expression very simply because that term of that you can see right here, 1 minus e to the power of 2 can be re-expressed as e plus 1 times e minus 1, which cancels out with this term. And you can finally write it just as a times 1 minus e. So the periapsis, or the closest point to the object that something is orbiting, will depend on the eccentricity. And you can see very clearly that if the eccentricity is 0, you just recover a. In a similar way, we can actually get an expression to get the furthest distance that an object will ever be if it's orbiting in an elliptical orbit. And this is achieved, instead of setting theta to 0, you set theta to pi. And with similar arguments, instead of getting a times e minus e, you get a times 1 plus e. And that is because, again, you expand this as 1 minus e times 1 plus e. And in this case, you're cutting the 1 minus e to get to the final expression. And this is very useful because sometimes you measure these two points, these two distances. They will allow you to actually calculate what is a and e. Or if you have an eccentricity and the average distance, you can calculate the furthest and the closest distance that an object will ever be. And this is incredibly useful to describe orbits in the solar system, for example.